Okay, topic two. We've already previously discussed what we do in a somewhat realistic zombie scenario, so this time the sky's the limit. What is your endgame setup for the zombie apocalypse? Now, we've previously discussed this separately off, you know, off the recording. That you guys haven't really thought about it in too much detail. So what I'll do is I'll say my scenario, and then we'll talk about the legitimacy of some other options, like, well, I'll tell you them once we get to that point. So my scenario is, my end game scenario is like an oil rig. We've talked about oil rigs before, how they would be, it would be a really cool place to go because A, it's sort of at sea, so the zombies, you know, they can't really swim. You could go off the Land of the Dead film where they can walk at the bottom of the fucking river, but that's stupid because dead bodies float, so that doesn't count.
They're up on stilts as well. The part where you live is nowhere near the sea.
Exactly. You're up, like, what, 20 metres off the sea, like, or more, probably.
Like scaffolding, isn't it?
And oil rigs are self-sufficient, I believe. I don't quote me on this, but I remember hearing that they're self-sufficient. So they somehow process a small amount of the oil, the crude oil, on the oil rig, and it creates power for the rest of the oil rig to power the operation. So you could, you know, have power for anything you want. You know, radios, you know, even like TV and whatever. You could power anything. You could have, you know, batteries for your phones and your torches, all that stuff, so you're golden there.
What are you hoping for us to pick holes in your great plan?
Well, not really. Oh, no, I'll go on the legitimacy of, I've got a couple of different options, and we'll talk about how good they are afterwards, because you guys haven't really talked about this, and like, I thought everybody thought about this sort of stuff. Like, it's like I was saying, maybe I'm just think too much stupid shit. But, yeah, anyway, so it's also got a water desalination plant on board, so takes the seawater, turns it into fresh water, and you have a bevy of like food at your fingertips in the ocean. So, you know, get some fishing trawlers nearby. You can probably make fuel for them from your oil rig and send them out, and you can have, so you've got food, a ready supply of food, water, fresh water, electricity, and fuel that you could trade with, you know, whatever's left of the Navy, you know, or whatever's left of, you know, whatever, you know, commercial fishing vessels that have decided to camp out at sea. So you've got like money that you can make, and you've got all that. But so that oil rig's one really good idea. So that's one end game scenario. The only problems with that are is I don't know how to operate an oil rig. So I don't know about you guys.
That's what I was going to say. You'd have to hope they left a lot of manuals lying around.
Or that there's still a couple of people manning that oil rig that know how to work it and could teach you. So
you've got to. Also, I don't like fish.
They might do. Yeah, but if it's a survival thing, what about squid?
Oh no!
Oh yeah, that's gonna be so much nicer.
I suppose I'd get on with it, but I'd be really moody the whole time.
Have they got like a fryer? Because I only like squid rings.
Probably. They're gonna have a kitchen, aren't they?
Let's have got a deep fryer.
Could we breed sea cows?
You could probably breed
cows
chickens.
Cows and dolphins.
Cows would be too big, but you could do chickens, probably. You know, they wouldn't be too... You keep them in pens and
all
stuff.
All right, then. All right.
I don't know what...
Battery farm.
I don't know if... I don't think you can feed them fish, so I don't know how what you'd do for their feed.
I think you can feed chickens nearly anything, to be honest.
Can you?
They're not dead picky.
But they need certain stuff to, like, form eggs and stuff, though, don't they?
They could get that out of the fish bones.
They can eat off their own eggs as well. They can... If you crunch that up, they can eat
their own shell.
And,
yeah.
Yeah, and it can... help produce more. So you just need sort of like grit, I think, little bits of grit.
Yeah.
I don't really know how it works. I'm not a fucking vet or anything, but yeah. So you could probably get like sort of chickens, and you could grow like plants and like have greenhouses on the top decks and stuff in some areas. I mean, it would be a bit makeshift and there wouldn't be a lot of space, but you could probably grow some sorts of fruit and vegetables, so, you know, or things to feed your chickens and whatnot. But then again, it's like I said, you're going on the arm of a leg.
It's like the old days at sea.
Yeah.
If you don't have something, you
scurvy.
Get the scurvy.
Yeah. Well, if you're in a hot hot region, you could grow lemon trees if you're in a hot region. But yeah, it's you're going on the arm of the leg that you've got to hope that you can find someone who knows how to operate the oil rig. That's why some other options, like my next end game scenario I would go for, is an island. because granted, you know, I mean, everybody goes to an island, but I've got a specific island in mind, because unless you've got an island that's it'd have to be massive to be able to have like an abundant amount of fresh water. So my thought is find one of those islands that's in like a massive lake. So it's in the middle of a massive lake. So there's a current as well, which will be helpful. It's fresh water. And so if you just like barricaded up, you build a little fort in the middle and then like build trenches around it in case raiders ever try and take over. And then you just take the perimeter of like the beaches and stuff and turn it like Normandy-esque and fill it with razor wire and landmines and stuff. So for if any raiders ever got an idea, because then if any raiders try to attack...
From?
What?
The razor wire and the landmines, where are you getting from?
Oh, well, you just look up where's the nearest razor wire warehouse that produces razor wire, and you've got an abundant, there's not going to be anyone there. And you just go raid it. Like you do all the other stuff you're going to want.
Like, do you think you're the only person that's got this idea?
Well, they're not going to be after I've said it. But... No, obviously not, but...
It's not a bad thing, though. People with a like-minded idea, you might get along. And you can't make do with just a handful of people. You'd need a decent-sized group. So potentially it's not a bad thing.
There's going to be other people with similar ideas, but there are more than one razor wire manufacturer in the world, you know, or in within the area.
Some of the Scottish islands would be good as well.
Yeah.
A lot of the islands around Scotland are on, they've not really got direct access to them. They're on cliffs.
Mm. Yeah, yeah.
Something like things, that could work. And it rains a whole lot there. So you'd have water.
Fresh water, yeah. So that's what it was like. The lake, I was thinking as well, though, because if any raiders were to attack you, they'd have to get on a boat to do it. And you would, someone on your watchtower would see them like, you know, 5 minutes out. So they could never really get the element of surprise on you. You'd always have time to prepare. And if it had like a decent current to it, and then zombies, like I said, zombies can't swim. Yeah. They could like flap about in the water, and maybe one or two will get dragged ashore every once in a while. But you could easily deal with them. And if your compound in the middle has got like solid concrete structures, which you'd imagine being on an island would give you time to prepare for that, then you'd have the structure. And even if, like, say, you know, 50 fell into a river from some shenanigans that happened upstream, most of them would get caught in either the razor wire or blown up in the landmines. And those that didn't, you could just pick off from your, you know, your solid concrete wall. You know, you stand on your wall and just, like, cap them or whatever. So
you could go like a Bond villain as well and get robot sharks.
You could do.
Get some scary wildlife in there.
Those resources might be slightly difficult to come by in the zombie apocalypse, but hey, you know, why not? You know, I did say sky's the limit, so you know.
If you go for Scotland as well, you might have a Loch Ness. Loch Ness.
Yeah.
Oh, train the Loch Ness. Perfect.
Yeah. But what if the Loch Ness gets turned into a zombie?
That's and then what it's I was like, gonna say.
And then it's like in Resident Evil 4. You know that thing in Resident Evil 4 when you're on that little boat. And the grappling hook.
I don't know. Well, you wouldn't have to worry about raiders anymore, would you?
That is true. You'd just have to worry about
if you can get
zombie to your
island,
thing.
You might be okay. It'd certainly be a deterrent.
Say bye-bye to like the Byrons.
Yeah. I suppose, though, if you become self-sufficient...
Unless he's too smart for all that, anyway, it'd be fine.
If you became self-sufficient, then you wouldn't need to go on basis. Supply runs, per se. Another thing about going with... if you had an island on a freshwater lake is fish. You could just cast out nets, and then ones that are going downstream would just get caught, and you could just, you know, again, fresh, abundant amount of food. So it's super cute. Another idea was a lighthouse. Little bit more difficult. There's not fresh water, and you'd have to worry about getting supplies back and forth, but it would be to take a lighthouse, even for raiders... would be difficult because, you know, you've got like your spiral staircase in the middle. You could just set up what are they called? Like a drawbridge in the stairs so they couldn't get access to it. So like partway up the, even if they managed to somehow get on the fucking lighthouse island, which is really difficult because the conditions are obviously usually quite choppy. Even if they could do that and get inside the lighthouse, they'd have to then climb a fucking spiral staircase where you would be at the top. You would have an elevated position that you could have fortified and like drawbridges part way up, so they couldn't, so they just get stuck and you just end up, it'd be like a shooting fish in a barrel. So it would be protected in that sense, but problem
they
with
are
that is
small inside.
Yeah, really, so you go a little stir crazy.
It's like a small apartment.
And supply runs. You'd have to go on supply runs. Maybe you could fish, but you definitely need to figure out like some way of getting fresh water. Again, maybe you could find some sort of small desalination plant. I think some like saline vessels have them. You know, obviously massive ships have them, but you couldn't have one of them because they'd be too big. But you know those little like sailing vessels that will like sail around the world in like X amount of time, or sail from, you know, London to New York or whatever.
Yeah.
You know, they have those little races and ones that get sponsored all the time. They have mini desalination plants. And maybe you could do something like that. But you probably have to go on supply runs quite often. So that would be quite risky.
That's only going to be for a small group, isn't it?
Yeah, that would have to be for a small group as well. So that would be quite tricky. The last one I thought up is a bunker. Now, I have major problems with bunkers. I think it's just a terrible idea. If Day of the Dead hasn't taught you, or even Night of the Living Dead, where they decide to go in the cellar, hasn't taught you that it's a bad idea, then, you know, you ain't very smart, and natural selection is going to get you anyway, so.
You deserve it.
So, I mean, like, bunkers are cool. You are fully protected. There's no zombies per se down there, but what if someone like dies? It depends on what, you know, rule set you're going by. But what if someone dies down there, you're trapped down there with a zombie, because that happens in Night of the Living Dead, doesn't it? So
we have another great option in the UK that the Americans won't have.
Castles. I thought you might go for that. That was one I forgot to add that. Yeah,
to be fair, they're going to be in high demand, but if you could lay your hands on one.
Not even just castles though, like what are they called? Not public houses. What are they called? You know, like massive fancy houses. What are they called?
Like manors.
Yeah, like some sort of country estate or whatever. Like if you go back like to an old one that's say like 400 or 500 years old, because this country like is a lot older in terms of like Western, you know, history than like America or somewhere like that, for example, or Australia. Mm. If you get one of those old manor houses that's like 500 years old, they always used to build them a little bit like a
they
castle
made
anyway.
They made them defensible, didn't they?
Yeah, and then they've got solid stone walls that are probably like, I don't know, two foot wide or something. Nothing's getting through that shit. Mm. So even if you just went for one of them, and some of them have got like little moats around them and stuff. So a castle, again, that's another good idea. But the downshot of that is people are accessible to you by land. And zombies probably aren't a worry, but as we all know in the zombie apocalypse, see what I did there?
Sounds like some dodgy porn video.
It does.
Yeah. People could get you, and that people are always in the zombie
the
things, probably
danger.
More dangerous than the zombies are. So that is the risk of that.
Get them with the boiling oil.
That is true.
Go all medieval on their ass.
That is true. I wonder how well a tank would do, though. I bet a tank could probably punch it through. Castle
there's probably
wall,
about
not
as many tanks as there are castles.
That
know.
Is true.
It's not everyone's going to have a castle, but not everyone's going to have a tank.
No, that is true.
No, in my look, they probably would.
A castle's probably much more easily accessible than a lot of the other options as well. Because, you know, like we're in the middle of England, so anything by the coast is going to be tricky to get to for
long
a little
haul.
While. Yeah. So, like oil rigs, islands, lighthouses, you know, and to be fair,
those are the sort of structures that are like have great security though, I suppose.
Yeah, like, well, because we had also in the Second World War we had to like fight off the German invasion, like, you know, we basically at one point in Europe it was basically us by ourselves just sort of like fighting the Germans, and then like America sending us like trade, and but it was pretty much us by ourselves. So we've got like loads of even First World War and Second World War outposts, old dilapidated outposts spread across the UK, so you could probably use one of them as well. They'd be quite defensible for obvious reasons, so quite good. But yeah, so what would What would be your favourite out of them? What option would you choose?
I don't know. I do like the idea of an oil rig. Like, that just seems like the most logical if we knew someone who could actually fucking run one and stuff.
It's a bit of a long shot, though. I'd say the island is probably the best all-rounder.
I mean, if you could definitely know you could secure the oil rig, that's probably the optimal strategy to go for. But you are going out on a limb, aren't you? Do you know?
The massive risk.
Also, if you do have problems and you do run out of things, it's going to be a nightmare getting back to land all the time. They are way out to sea.
Yeah, and often they get stuff brought in via helicopter. And I don't know how to fly a helicopter, so you'd have to hope you'd have one. I mean, they can also go via boat, but again, there can't be any swell, really. It has to be really good weather conditions to be able to traverse back and forth by boat. So let's say you go out by boat on a raiding run and the weather changes. You could be stranded on land away from your oil rig for 4 days or something. I mean, granted, you probably have some safe houses, but do you really want to stay in a not very secured location for 4 days or more, you know?
The island definitely sounds better. It's just if you go for like the lake and everything, it's pretty much got everything that you need, like bar power and stuff, really, hasn't it? But
you could probably set up some like water turbines
on a little island. You could have everything you need and never need to go back to land.
Exactly.
And that is the dream,
isn't it? Yeah, if you become fully self-sufficient, and you're probably not going to, if you camouflage your area so it's not obvious there's a compound on the island, you know, you fill it with like woodland and camo netting and shit, so people don't know. You're not going to get like people going, oh, please let me join, and begging and stuff, and you don't know whether they're good guys or raiders pretending, you know, to be in need just to get in and do intel and stuff. So you wouldn't need to go out, you wouldn't need to have all the trouble of going raiding for like loot and food and shit. So you could just sit, just chill, just wait it all out. Because that's another thing with the zombie stuff. I don't know, I can't remember whether we touched on it in the last thing. In the real world, if you're taking if you're taking it out of the supernatural ones where it's like, oh, the hell, the hell spilled out, they spilled over from hell, hell's not taking any more souls or whatever. If you take it on like a virus thing, the body would probably decay at some point when the food source ran out. So, like, my logic always is with zombies is the thing that keeps them going, why they always go for the brains, is because there's something in the brain that nourishes them and keeps them alive, if you will, or keeps their body regenerating. But when that runs out, when they run out of meat or brain, they're going to turn into mush eventually. And, like, you're not going to have, like, Jason and the Argonauts skeletons bobbing about, you know, like...
It's a real thing, even in things like The Walking Dead, when you see the heavily rotted ones.
Yeah.
The muscles wouldn't work anymore. They wouldn't be able to support. So I think, to be honest, you're more likely to get like a fresher sort of zombie around, and that would have a limited lifespan.
Yeah, I think it would as well. I think you probably only need to wait out. Let's say if something was the feeding part was keeping them regenerating for longer. You wait till most people are wiped out. You've probably only got to wait maybe 4-5 years tops before it's almost completely safe against zombies anyway. There'd still be people who would be a problem. But then there's no zombies, so there's an abundant resources. There's like, if you imagine that, you know, there's probably like, what, I don't know the exact figure, but there's probably like 50 million people in the UK. If you imagine that there's only now 500,000, we've got enough resources,
plenty of room to stretch.
Exactly. There's enough, well, you know, there's bountiful resources for everybody left over. So, you know, I think if you sit and the sit and wait out mentality will work in the real world. So, you know, so just getting secure on a, like an island or something and waiting out would be golden, I think. So
I agree.
So what would you guys pick? You guys would pick the island? Although,
well, we've come up with a plan, haven't we?
I've got to say,
at least we're prepared.
The castle would be tempting, you know, so.
Well, at the end of the day,
there's something quite awesome about that.
Yeah, if you roaming around with your broadsword on your back and maybe your shield. Or you could go out in a suit of armour. You'd be clunky as fuck, but they couldn't bite you, could they?
You'd be perfectly safe, yeah.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, guys, like, it doesn't really matter what I say. I'm following you two anyway, so...
Yeah.
I ain't surviving on my own. No. God.
Well, of course you come in with us. We'll need bait from time to time.
That is true.
Such a bitch.
You probably make good bait as well, because you'd be like screaming and shit. It. So, you know, you'd be a good distraction.
So I'm not even going to be bait by, like, you know...
Plus, the upshot is, if we're ever
you
chased...
You are making me bait by force.
If we're ever chased by zombies, all I have to do is outrun you to survive. I don't need to...
True, I may not be the fastest runner, but I reckon I could throw Lou quite far.
Mm.
If I've got, like, the right advantage, I reckon I could throw her behind me.
Yeah, maybe, but you've just told her this, so she knows if we're ever on the run from zombies.
I fell for it anyway.
It's not been the first time that I've, like, picked you up and launched you, Lou. I'll do it again.
You make it sound like, who the fuck are you? Like, Brock Lesnar. Running around launching people all over the shop.
Just for the record, I'm the tallest, like...
Body slamming.
...woman out of our tallest woman out of our family. Every other woman is a midget. So
that's right.
Yeah, quite.
She's 6'4", hairy.
Built like a brick shit house.
Rock ain't got fuck all.
He has hormonal problems.
He has. You said he has hormonal problems. That's even worse. That's a cold burn, that. And that doesn't even make sense. A cold burn, hot burn, cold burn, whatever.
You can get cold burn.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. You can
freeze burn. Yeah. Off like spraying stuff. But that avoids the point that Louise is a bitch.
On that note, we shall leave this topic there.